Don John was here to bring you up to speed with the inspection, because that's what I had to bring you up to speed on that. I did get a call as soon as Bob walked out of the office from Paul, from Century Roofing. He said that the material will be delivered tomorrow and the labor will begin on Monday. So, I asked him, I said, I assume you're gonna have everything roped off for safety and whatnot. And Bob had brought up the fact that because he's exceeding the two-person, employee under his liability, he wanted workers' comp, and Paul agreed, said absolutely no problem. He'll provide us with a certificate of liability.
Are they gonna be employees?
Not ours.
I don't, I thought he said that they were his, they work for the company.
Okay, no, I just want.
So the question is if they're independent?
If they're independents, they need to have their own liability and their own workers' comp, because they're not covered under his.
No, they'd be subs, basically.
Well, they're his subs, so.
Well, they are independent, they're 1099, so they're independent contractors.
Right, they're sub, they'd be subcontractors that he's hiring, so.
But they're not covered under his policy.
Right, but I believe in our contract, he's supposed to let us know if he has any subs, so if he doesn't let us know, then they are employees.
I thought he said he had four employees, but I'll double check that for sure.
All right, because I think.
Yeah, because he's got his son-in-law, I can give you the four he's got. Himself, the son-in-law, that's his, assistant super or whatever, the son-in-law that drives the dump truck, and the girl that works in the office. Those are the four employees he has. So my concern is for the residents of this town, heaven forbid, he's got some, he's hired somebody, he's 1099, they fall off that roof. So I just wanna make sure either he's got them classified as employees, or if they're his, and I'll use your term sub, but it's still a 1099 that they're using. They have to have their own liability, their own workers' comp, because they're not covered under his.
I think it's in the contract, they're supposed to have liability and workers' comp anyway.
And what he did is he showed us what he had. And, you know, making the assumption that everyone's covered, I, you know, being in the industry and knowing how they misclassify people, they use them differently, I don't wanna see us get into a situation that happens somewhere else.
I really agree.
I'll clarify it again, because we talked.
Because there is no problem with them going and getting that workers' comp extended to cover additional employees. Because all they do is audit him the following year, and they charge him respectively, but. If they're not employees, they need to be able to prove that when they come on the job site, before they get on the roof.
Right, exactly, because I think that's what it says in our contract, that any subcontractor, they gotta let us know, be approved by us. And a part of that approval is, like you said, having that insurance.
But, you know, thinking back is, the fact is, he's, he showed he has workers' comp coverage, but we're making the assumption they're all employees. And all it takes is one.
Absolutely.
Got it.
You got a chance, you gonna keep an eye on, you know, follow up with that?
Well, actually, you know, because the building inspector should be watching them, so he should be making sure that they have insurance coverage before they go up there.
That's right, he's gonna be a clerk of the works, that's right.
Because I said to Lean, it's not her responsibility, the building inspector's gotta watch what they're doing, he's gonna make sure that they have the slate and the fasteners and whatever, and if those guys are all, if he says these three guys I've hired out, and they're not on his workers' comp, they need to have that proof with them.
Sounds good to me.
All right, I'll let John know.
So, you know, we really need to think about making a building inspector, you know, so.
A more permanent position, or?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's always been on our radar, per se, but it's kinda fallen off.
Oh, as far as filling it?
Yeah, as far as filling it, John's actually the deputy building inspector, filling in, because we lost that, so.
Right, and I know that sometimes he's run haggard. And, you know, at some point in time, with the developments you're having in town, it's gonna take a lot more time than he can.
Do you want me to post it, that we have a vacancy? Or typically, we post in-house first?
Right, the it's just a discussion for right now, I mean, cause we got budget problems, I mean, because we didn't budget for it really now.
Yep.
Yeah, I think that's an item we can look at in the budget to make sure that there's something we can do, you know?
We got the 22 house subdivision coming up in Grape, at the end of Grapevine there on Outlook Estates.
And I know originally they were kind of cross-training or Steve in that position to be able to fill in for, you know, electrical inspections or footing inspections and whatnot, but he's already got too much on his plate already.
I see.
Get him out of the office and it's just, as soon as he walks out the door, someone walks in, they want help, they want assistance now.
Yep.
So, I think it's gonna work. Something to think about then.
Throw on our list for budget discussion. Actually. Well then, I think that's about it, so let's go around the table.
Just wanna let you know that the budget memos have been distributed and scheduling is already begun.
And that Excel spreadsheet will close it.
Yeah, I've got two budgets next week, starting a little bit earlier. And originally you said one department per meeting and the more I thought about it, I just wouldn't have enough time to get everything pulled together for you in a timely fashion. So we have just Old Home Day next Thursday, Highway Department, and then I'll try to, I'll piggyback the short, the small budgets together.
Small, the big one?
Yeah.
You know, like the Old Home Day with the budget, you know, Highway, that's kinda good, cause Jeff's got a big budget and they're a small budget.
Yeah, so try to monitor those a little bit.
Yeah, it's kinda brutal when you're trying to do like the fire, police and highway all at one night, I mean, we're here till like 10:30, 11.
We try, if they're already tied up with one big department, I won't book them on the same night, I won't, I'll give them, ask them to pick another option.
So, are you good with the chance?
I'm good.
Okay.
Got a lot of work to do for next week.
Anything else? Mr. Cole?
No, fine.
I'm good.
No, I spoke my piece.
All right, I see, we don't have a non-public on here, right, or else?
Nope.
Okay, so we'll be sure. All right, then I'll open up for public comment.
Okay, thank you.
Woody?
Yeah, for now, I'll say.
Linda?
Did you guys get any sleep?
I got about 3 hours sleep before I had to go to work, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't get much more than that either. I did wanna talk to you, first of all, thank you for everything you did at the elections. It's nice to have a board of selectmen who works the elections. As we evolve with the rules and regulations, I think there's gonna be more training and stuff that you'll have to keep up with, but fortunately we get a reprieve next year and there's only one. And it will not be scrutinized, it'll be scrutinized differently, closely but differently than this one.
Right.
As far as elections goes, I'm electioned out, so I'll just move on to something else.
Oh, real quick, honey, we had what, 1,841?
I knew you were gonna ask, I brought the numbers with me. We had 1,841 votes cast.
What was the percentage?
80.8, which was lower than the 2012 presidential election, we had 87% then.
Really?
Yeah, we had a higher percentage, we had less people in town, we had a higher percentage. But it was a lot.
Yeah, it was the same ones voting this time, the other same old.
No. What I wanted to just give you food for thought tonight, because we are approaching budget time and I'm still in election mode and I need to be there for a few more days because I still have work related to the elections to do. But going into budget mode, when the deputy position was removed the year before, of course I lost that block, and then this year town meeting, the voters brought that back. So I need to get a feel for how to plan for this budget this year. Obviously, I don't wanna hire Gary for months and then kick him to the curb because it's a new budget year and there's not gonna be funding for him.
Well, you know, the curb is only right there where he lives.
I know, you know, would you believe he's asking for mileage?
Shoot, I wouldn't doubt, yeah, no comment.
He wears that as sneakers. My plan, but if, I just need a little bit of, I don't even know what I need besides sleep. I am hoping to open up on Fridays. If this is all approved and, you know, when I put it in the budget and it's not shot down right off the bat, I'd like to open up part of the day Friday, and that will be Gary's main day to work. If we open the office 6 or 7 hours a day, I was thinking something like 8 to 3. Seven hours a day. There's still an hour closeout time, and there's still a bank run, which round trip is about an hour. So that's a 9 hour day for one day a week. We need to have some overlap time. He's still mentoring. He will always be, I'm still mentoring from time to time. We will always need some overlap time. And he can't really learn the job in that teensy little amount of hours. So I'm thinking 12 to 15 hours total. So he would be one day on his own. We would overlap another partial day. And he would fill in if I'm on vacation. My dilemma is if I do take a week off for vacation, the office is going to be open more hours. I will put him over 40 hours and we can't have that. I don't know what the labor laws are for all of that, and I don't want a budget for that. But I know people want Fridays, but then they would have to, everyone would have to be understanding that from time to time, it's gonna have to be closed, because we can't have Gary working 50 hours in a week.
Well, I mean, you know, for retirement purposes, you know, if it was a retiree from the state or something like that in the retirement system, that would be the crux of the issue. I mean, as a part-timer, he could work over.
If it's a temporary position, it doesn't fall into the category of any kind of a danger. He'd be paid time and a half.
Okay, that's what I mean. I'm thinking
money-wise. But you just described, you mentioned half a day on Fridays, and then you described 8 to 3.
Yeah.
Partial day?
A partial day on Friday.
So
8 to 3.
Isn't that what you have? Oh, you were open 7:30 to 3:30.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just shifting the day by half an hour at each.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, so that's a full day to me.
So, okay, never mind, it's a full day. Only partially here.
Okay.
So he would work a full day, but maybe just shift the time a little bit. The reason I wanted to shift it, I wanted to close at 3, is because the bank deposit has to be made, and if we're open on Fridays, and everybody's been claiming, you need to be open Fridays, you need to be open Fridays, if everybody's gonna pile in at Friday, 5 of 3, he's not going to get out of the office in time to go to the bank because there is an entire process of closing out locally and with the state. And we have to make sure that he's able to get to the bank before they close. So, and then not knowing if it's going to be like a Friday's going to be procrastinator's day, I just don't know. This is all new for me, too. I'm just throwing it out there. This is what I'm thinking. You know, in all fairness, I need to tell you this.
Mm-hmm.
I know there is money in this left in the budget that I can start it this year. Because he didn't start working until May. So,
mm-hmm.
It was a whole month later than I had planned. So we have wiggle room to start it now. But I don't want to. I'd love to start it now if we could. With a Merry Christmas memo to the town, we're going to be open Fridays.
Speaking of just as myself, not
for
these two gentlemen, but I believe the consensus of the board was to do a level services budget. Level services at this point in time doesn't include Fridays. So
that's fine. That's why I'm bringing
it
up.
So I would, my opinion, and again, it's just my opinion. These gentlemen can weigh in however they want. I would suggest you take and put your budget together as level services, and then any extras you want, like it says in the memo, bring forth those numbers and justify it accordingly, as in, you know, the townspeople want this, or, you know, so we can have that discussion, and expand the services or not.
Okay, that's a thought. Now, I'm running all this through my head, and I wanna make sure we're on the same page. Level services, I believe the board for 2016, allotted $2,000 for a deputy. So, do I put it back to $2,000, chew it all up between January? It'll all be gone by the time town meeting rolls around. So you see my dilemma. Last year was the first year we didn't have a deputy 12 hours a week for a lot of years. So, if we just put it back the way it was before it got taken away, that would take care of Fridays.
Granted, the budget was proposed without the deputy or minimal amount for the deputy. But over the course of the year, the actual service was with a deputy, so I think you could easily.
You mean this year's service?
This year's services was with a deputy, so I think, again, that's just my opinion. I think you could easily extrapolate that level services means the way you're doing business right now.
So, the way I'm doing business right now is he's here.
Correct.
12 whatever hours a week, so we would have a lot of overlap time. You mean keep him as he is now? Are you talking the $2,000 line item or what came in on the warrant article?
What came in on the warrant article, cause that's what the services.
That, okay, that's what I need to know.
Yeah.
So I can take that figure with the roughly a .7, figure how many hours it is.
And Lynn will be able to get you, you know, after next week, she'll be able to get you the actual amount of what the raise would be.
I can calculate that part.
Right, but we haven't approved it yet. We don't know if that's the direction we're going.
Right, I can calculate that part. I'm just looking to see. So, I'm trying to avoid, because one of the, things that the voters made clear at town meeting was they didn't like that we overlap so much. If there's two of us here, that we should both be open.
Again, that's part of managing your office, so if you see a different way of doing it, that might incorporate where you're doing right now. Now, that's all part of the discussion.
And that was why I was thinking Fridays, because when we're both here, I would love to, for both of us to be able to serve the public, but I have my own block of time and I have other duties I have to fulfill. And I can't wait on the public and do the other things as well. So that's why I thought Fridays would be a good thing.
Gentlemen, are you, the board members?
Yeah, no, I'm pretty good with, you know, going forward with the budget, and I like that you're Fridays.
Yeah, and.
Then you figure out how to make that work. Great.
And that's why I'm juggling with not overlapping.
Yeah.
Using him for this set number of hours a week, and he and I have discussed it, and I've said to him, if this goes, you know, if this flies, and you find on a Friday, you had a whole bunch of last minute people, and you wind up working 11 hours instead of 9 hours, then the following week, when we have that little bit of a difference where we do have an overlap, I said, then the following week you will work 2 hours less so that we can keep the hours down that way. So that overlap is almost like a little pad too, because we can't help it if people come in as we're closing.
And it's all part of managing your budget and your office accordingly.
Right, that's, so I'm explaining to you, I have worked that part as best I can, but I can't control when people come in.
Well, you know they will on Friday.
And they do.
At the end of the month, are you kidding me?
They do now without anybody there.
Well, that means you get things like we had a couple moved in from another state. It was the day that I was out. They moved here from another state 3 minutes before closing. They walked in with 3 titles that had to be changed from another state to New Hampshire. It's an incredible amount of work. I can get through it pretty quickly, but somebody like Gary, who's only here a handful of hours and still learning, that takes him much, much longer to do. So you can tell me it's all how you manage, and you know I have to do it a certain way, but we're kind of at the mercy of the public too.
I totally understand.
Okay.
We have that same issue with their office as well, and the building department. It's par for the course.
But they get to close a block of time and pull the shade down where there's no customers. I don't get to do that when I'm working.
This is a public comic, can I make?
No, not yet. We're still talking.
Oh, yeah,
I understand that, that you'd be referring to that when she's done.
So I think that was about it, I'm just throwing it out there, so I will, I would just like to get the number of hours back that I used to have at least. And that you, the two of you at least may recall that I was hoping to increase it from 12 hours a week to 15 hours a week. I'm doing the best I can here, but this town is quickly growing and there are demands on my services as well and my time.
You're gonna say something about?
Yeah, well, all I was gonna say is when they passed that warrant article, the intention was to have more service. So I think that at least you can use that number, you know, to make, and then you can make an argument. If you need another number and so we can see what that number is, we can decide, you know, if that's feasible or, cause I'm gonna say this, we're gonna be coming from a lot of different directions this year. And everybody just wants a little, but it's gonna get to be a great amount before too long, you know?
Absolutely, oh, I get that too. This was an amount that I had up until a year ago too. It wasn't anything I decided I didn't need anymore and did away with.
And I understand, and like I said, the warrant article spoke for itself. People want that level of service. So I think that's what we were planning on doing, is carrying the same thing forward. At least that's what my intention was.
And that's what I needed to know, that, that you were thinking along those lines. And I and my thought was, listening to what people said in March, was that they wanted a, they didn't want just a second body in the room, they wanted another day. Something about Fridays, I'm gonna call it Procrastinator's Friday.
Are you all set?
I think that's
about. We have a timeline of 9:30, so I'd like to get to it if I could.
No problem, I'm all set, have a good evening.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Young lady.
Corin was gonna say something.
Oh, what, we're coming around here, okay.
She's okay.
She's in the.
She's all set, she's my daughter.
Oh, you're good, but Paul Collins, she wants to talk, she can. Alrighty, Corin?
I just have a quick question. When you're, say your office closing at a certain time, do you lock the doors at that time and only the people that are inside get finished being serviced, or do you keep the doors unlocked until everybody's done? I'm just curious how the ending day works. Say if your office is supposed to be closed at what time? What time is the normal day?
Mondays and Wednesdays end at, supposed to end at 3:30.
Now is the door locked at 3:30 or is it still kept unlocked so people can keep walking in?
The outside doors are open until 4:00, so people come in for the other departments.
Okay.
And not for his, for her department, they're coming in for
right,
our department.
Other business going
because
on,
her
you're
screen
still
goes
in.
Down at 3:30.
Oh, so you close your screen at,
yeah.
at that time? Okay,
yeah.
that,
but
that's something I never knew.
I came in on Friday, because of all the election stuff, I came in Friday, I'm in my office, where the door opens, somebody's got a little sticker that you put on your license plate. He goes, I got a problem, this got ripped, and dude, it's Friday and I'm closed and I got an election. No, but I just, they know that I'm here and it's a small town and y'all offer that service because that's what we're here to do, to serve the people. But I'm preparing for an election and somebody stops in, I can't turn them away. I can't. It's a, and Gary certainly can lock the door, pull the shade when he's here, but when I'm here, if somebody knocks on the door, I'm going to respond to their needs.
Thanks for answering my question.
Okay.
Woody, I'm coming in on Friday from now on.
Good luck with that. Folks, you can have this conversation later on because it's getting late and our witching hour turns at 9:30, so I just want to go around the board real quick if anybody's there.
No, good.
No, I'm fine.
I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So
I'll make a motion to adjourn. I'll second.
I'll make a second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.